In this video, we will discuss about very interesting topic of chapter reproduction, that is sexual reproduction in flowering plants. In our previous video, we discussed about vegetative propagation in plants, that is mode of asexual reproduction in plants, in which only vegetative parts of plant, that is stem, root, leaf, they play role to produce new plant. Now, sexual reproduction in flowering plants. We can split this line into two parts: sexual reproduction, flowering plants. As already discussed about this mode of reproduction, in this mode of reproduction, two sexes are involved, that is male and female, and there is role of gametes in this method of reproduction. In your class 9, you studied about five kingdom system of classification under chapter diversity in living organisms. Five kingdom system of classification was given by R.H. Whittaker. According to that system of classification, how many kingdoms are there? Five: Kingdom Monera, Kingdom Protista, Kingdom Fungi, Kingdom Animalia, Kingdom Plantae. Kingdom Plantae is further divided into divisions like Thallophyta, Bryophyta, Pteridophyta, Gymnosperms and Angiosperms. So flowering plants, they are called angiosperms. And how angiosperms they reproduce? They reproduce by sexual reproduction. And how many sexes are involved in this mode of reproduction? Two sexes, male and female. So in angiosperms, where their sexual organs are present, so sexual organs of plant present in their flowers, means male sex organ and female sex organ, that is present within flower. So flower play very important role in sexual mode of reproduction in angiosperms. Structure of flower and its parts. This basal part, okay, to which other floral appendages are attached. Other parts of flower, they all are attached to this part. So this part is called receptacle or thalamus. And these green leaf-like structures, they are called sepals. Colorful part of a flower, colored part of flower, these are called petals. Here you can see these are petals. And this middle part, it is called pistil or carpel. It is female reproductive part of a flower, female reproductive organ of flower, that is called pistil. And pistil has how many parts? Top part, that is called stigma. This middle part, which is acting as a link between stigma and ovary, it is called style. So style is connecting stigma to the ovary. Basal part is called ovary. This is style. This is stigma. Together these three, they form pistil or carpel, which is female reproductive part of a flower. And here it is male reproductive part of flower. Anther, filament. Separately you can see here anther, filament, together form stamen. Stamen is male reproductive part of a flower. Now we will discuss about their role. What is the function of sepal? What is the function of petals? What is the function of pistil? What is the function of this stamen? First part is receptacle. So basal part, to which other floral appendages are attached, that is called receptacle or thalamus. Okay, this portion is called thalamus or receptacle. And this structure, okay, it is called pedicel. This flower stem or stalk, it is called pedicel. And this part is called thalamus or receptacle. Other floral parts, they are attached to the receptacle. Then next, that is sepal. green leaf-like structure which are attached to the thalamus. Here, these green leafy structure, okay, these green leafy structure, they are called sepal. So, green leafy structure which are attached to the thalamus, they are called sepals. What is the function of sepal? To provide protection to the flower when it is in bud condition. Here you can see, here this flower is in its bud form, and these green leafy structures, these are sepals, they are providing protection to the flower when it is in bud condition. So, to provide protection in its initial stage, that is the function of sepal. Now about colorful part of flower, that is petals. What is the function of petals? To attract insects. For what? For pollination. Okay, so these petals, these attract insects to facilitate pollination. We will discuss about pollination later on. Next part is stamen. Anther, filament, together they form stamen, which is male reproductive part of a flower. Anther part of stamen, it forms pollen grains, and inside pollen grains male gametes are present. So what is the function of stamen? It helps in formation of male gamete. It helps in formation of pollen grains. And next is carpel, which is female reproductive part of flower. And inside ovary part of carpel, there is formation of female gamete. Female gamete present inside the ovary within ovule. In this flower, clearly you can see these structures. These are stamen, okay, male part, and the middle part, which is light in color, it is female part, pistil or carpel. And these are petals, and these green leafy structures, they are called sepals, and it is called flower stalk, flower stem or pedicel. So this is all about parts of a flower, structure of a flower. Types of flowers. There are two types of flowers, unisexual and bisexual. Uni means single. So, the flowers in which out of male and female organ only one is present. Like out of stamen and pistil, only one is present within a flower. That flower is called unisexual flower. Example of unisexual flower is papaya and watermelon. Then second type is bisexual one. Bisexual flowers are those flowers in which both male and female sex organs are present within one flower. Example is hibiscus and mustard. Or here in this flower, it is flower of gulmohar. Biological name of gulmohar is Dahlonyx regia. In this flower, you can see here in the middle, it is the female part, which is called pistil, which is light in color. And these all parts, these are male part, anther on the top, and this structure is called filament. So both parts are present within one flower. This flower is called bisexual one. So bisexual flowers are those flowers in which male and female parts both lies within one. That is called bisexual one. Now pollination. What is pollination? Transfer of pollen grain from anther of stamen to the stigma of carpel. That is called pollination. So before fusion of gametes, before fertilization, as you studied in your class 8 about pollination. What is pollination? Transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma of the flower. That is called pollination. And pollination is of two types, self-pollination and cross-pollination. Self pollination means transfer of pollen grain from anther to the stigma of same or genetically similar flower. In simple way, you just understand transfer of pollen grain. Where pollen grains they are formed? They are formed inside anther of stamen. Anther is part of stamen. So pollen grains, they formed inside anther and they transfer from anther to the stigma. So it is happening within one flower. Okay, as we already discussed about this flower, it is bisexual one. In the middle there is pistil or carpel and it is surrounded by female part. So transfer of pollen grain from anther to stigma part within same flower, it is called self pollination. And sometimes what happens, there is transfer of pollen grains from anther of one flower to stigma of another flower, it is called cross pollination. So cross pollination, transfer of pollen grains from anther of one flower to stigma of another flower. How many types of pollination are there? Two types, self pollination and cross pollination. Different pollinating agent, they are helping in pollination, they are helping in transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma of flower. So pollinating agents are water, wind, insects, birds and also other animals. So those who are helping in pollination, those who are helping in transfer of pollen grains, they are called pollinating agents. And how many types of pollination are there? Self pollination and cross pollination. So two types of pollination are there. In next video, we will discuss about fertilization and structure of seed.